Now I'm just going to talk a little bit about the access type settings in your photo job. So I'm going to open up my photo jobs. Again, doesn't matter where you are in the account, just click on photo jobs at the top along your navigation bar. I'm just going to open up this test job. If you'd watched already the job setup video, then you'll have seen me setting this up so far. We do get some questions a lot about sort of the different access types that we offer. So I'm just going to very quickly talk about the main methods here and hopefully answer any questions that you have regarding that. So regular QR tagging is pretty self-explanatory. This just allows us to generate a certain number of blank QR cards, which you'll then write the name on and the class potentially as well when you're in the school or the nursery taking the photos. So of course, enter the exact number of heads and allow for a few spares just in case you have spills or some stuff gets knocked over, whatever it might be. We're dealing with children after all, so a few spares is never a bad idea. Now, just another additional point alongside that, the cards are usable between jobs. So if you do have spares left over after your first job, feel free to just keep those and you don't need to throw them in the bin or anything like that. They can be used as spares in a job in future. Now, the other method here that's most commonly used with schools, not so much with nurseries, although it is possible, and it would, of course, potentially make your workflow a little bit easier, and that would be to get a list of names. Now, this is very common if you're working in a primary school or a secondary school that uses some sort of ID management system. A lot of people have heard of SIMS. There's also a few other formatted systems like CMIS and ISAMS. Again, these all do more or less the same thing. But again, this allows us to then enter that data into the system. So again, the school will send that information over to you prior. We can then enter the data into GotPhoto. This allows us to have everything in there ready to go. The last then step of the process for us to be able to create the data export for the school is just to tie the images together with the data that we've already entered. So we're just updating the images. That's where you come in. You're going in, taking the photos on the day. Our system will then automatically take the first image from the gallery and add that to the SIMS or the data management export, whatever format it is that they're using. So that would be the list of names. And again, you need to upload this in a CSV format. Do please refer to the templates down here. So these just allow the correct headings that we'll accept in our system. So in other words, we need to have the headings matching what our template says in order for the data to be processed correctly so that you can then provide the school with everything after the shoot. Again, if you have any questions further to that, do feel free to get in touch with support. Anyway, the next one I just wanted to quickly talk about was registration for photo day. Again, this is handy if you are pre-planning a shoot, and it's especially handy over the last little while with everything that's been happening with coronavirus, where perhaps some parents don't want to have their children involved in certain group events like photo day, for example. So this is good. We can send out a link, or rather you need to get the school or the nursery to send out a link prior to the shoot. Good 6 weeks in advance if possible, maybe even a little bit longer. And again, you can send out a couple of reminder emails leading up to the shoot date. But this allows parents to basically register their kids manually. So they'll basically get a link from the school or the nursery. They can then go in, follow that link and enter the details in there. Now we can just set up an album structure in the job as well before. And this also allows parents to drop in the exact class of their child as well. So you'll receive all the information from them. We've already got their email address. So again, we're just generating the QR cards on the day. But as again, we don't really need to send these out because we've already got all of the contact information that we would normally be getting by using the QR cards. So again, we're getting the information up front. This is slightly different from a regular workflow. And again, this is very useful if you do have shoots where perhaps not everybody is comfortable being photographed, but there is still some openness to having a photo day. So again, that's a potential option there too. Finally, then manual tagging. This just allows us to take the photos on the day, figure it out later. So again, if this seems like something that maybe would be easier if there's a very chaotic shoot that you have coming up, but it's a limited number of heads, perhaps then the QR tagging doesn't make sense. In this instance, what you can do is just manually tag the images after. So we're just going to click on the first image in the gallery of that child, tag that one, and then when we come to the next child, we're going to tag their first image. And again, it's just pretty much doing what the QR cards do manually, so pretty self-explanatory. But those are the four main options for the access type. I hope that has helped to clear up any further questions that you had in regards to that. Thanks very much. Thank you so much for checking out this instructional video. We do appreciate though that you may still require some assistance. If this is the case, pay attention now to the details on screen and feel free to get in touch.